So good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I just congratulated. While you're round up, please put your hands together again for the Four Tops. They're still in the building. Cheers for love. Better. Without further ado, these gentlemen coming to the stage and entertaining millions of people all over the world, and tonight is your turn to be entertained. So without further ado, put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen, for Tony!
I'm gonna make you mine. wonderful kind of thing that Mr. Ron Kaiser had a little research. But you know what? As I was saying, let's reminisce on some of this.
Ain't too proud to be, baby, baby. Yeah. 1971, the Temptations had the very first platinum record. Let's unwind some memories.
Each day in my window, I watch her when she passes by.
We all can sing this one tonight. Come on.
I say to myself,
such a kind. Oh, you're so kind. Yes, you are.
Such a lucky kind.
Thank you.
17, 18 years old, and here we are, where we are. Hey, we still having fun, you know. So with that being said, I'd like to let you know, like I said, there will never ever be a recording company like Motown Records. Now, yes, you can give it up, that's right. You know, the reason I said that is because you never would imagine how much money Barry got to start on time. His family loaned him $800. Ooh, that's cheap stuff. When he sold it, he got that show enough money. Yes. You know, so I'm so glad that we are part of something that is very, you know, got a lot of history, you know, with it, behind it, and what have you. Because, like I said, there will never, ever be a recording company like Motown Records. A reason being, not only is Motown known for all those wonderful hits that came out of that 2648 West Grand Boulevard in Detroit, Michigan, no other company. You know, New York City, Chicago, Los Angeles, Memphis, down South Alabama. They were known for all the recording companies, the hits. I'll do my thing. Yeah, and you know, but you come to see a little two-story family flat, 2648 West Grand Boulevard. Now, you know, Detroit has always been known for the, as the big three, Ford, General Motors, and Chrysler. Not anymore. I mean, sure, they still recognize, but we have to add a new thing to it. Ford, General Motors, and Chrysler, and Motown. That's right. You know, even though I'm in LA, but I still have folks in Detroit, and when I go to Detroit, I would go up to Motown, and they have a map at Motown, and it's got a lot of little dots all over. So I asked her, what do these dots mean? And she said, Otis, that would mean everybody from those little dots all over the world came to see Motown. That's the kind of histrionics that Motown possesses, you know. And also what made Motown so uniquely different was that they had a division called Artist Development. Yes, and that would mean we would have had to go to school. Oh yeah, Motown Artist Development, which comprised of Charlie Atkins, Maurice King, Lon Fontaine, and John Allen. And so one day Barry Gordy and Harvey Fuqua, they were talking, and Barry said, Harvey, I have all these talented young artists, but they need to be groomed, you know, so when they present themselves, you know, they would be presented in the best light. So Harvey said, well, I know somebody that can really help us out. So Barry said, go ahead and get that person. Now, here are the four people that really helped us out. First, Charlie Atkins, Lon Fontaine, Maurice King, and Johnny Allen. Now, Charlie Atkins was a step master. You know, I must first give credit to the one that's got us doing all this choreography. One of the best, and I love him, and I miss him, Paul Williams. Yeah, and we have his nephew, Adrian Williams, playing guitar for us. That's right. So, they would call the whistles, and we would have to be there. They would call it like 10 or 11 o'clock in the morning, all the way to 5 or 6 in the evening. Now that was the classic tips. So after we thought we were finished rehearsing, five of us, David, Eddie, Paul, Melvin, and myself, we would do the long range thing, running on to the note. Charlie said, Maurice King, rather. Boy, yeah, come back and sit down. I said, come on, Pops, you've been rehearsing us all this. Shut up, boy, come here and sit down. Yeah, that's the way they talk to us, you know. Now, Maurice King would say, there's four things that I want you guys to remember. And what I'm about to say is not just only for the temptation. Every one of you in this here building, it applies to you also. The first one, you cannot tell anybody about their politics. That's right. Yeah, okay. I'm gonna see if you can come up on this next one. You cannot tell anybody about their religion. All right, third one, don't even try to tell anybody about their money. The fourth one, every group got one. Yeah, he's completely wrong. You cannot tell anyone about their lovemaking. Y'all laugh at that one, okay. But you know, the four of them, they taught us a lot. You know, like I said, Maurice King, vocals, you know, he would teach us about close harmonies, you know, that we would have to do like the four freshmen. the harmony, the modern jazz, you know, the kind of harmony that you gotta stay on your note, because if you got off of it, boy, get your ass back up on that note. That's the way they would talk to us. We love us, but it would be very cool guy. I said Maurice King, Charlie Atkins. He was the stepmaster. Oh, I mean, you had to do this stuff just right. You know, and a lot of what we're doing, you see when we get to do Trio Like a Lady, Charlie Atkins. His stuff was so mathematical, you had to go to school and, boy, move your, you can't go to Cleveland if you're in Cleveland. Move your ass. That's the way you can talk to us, just like that. Lon Fontaine, another noted choreographer, and also another, Johnny Allen, our keyboardist. So we had some wonderful thespians that would teach us how to be in show business. So now, with that being said, we have a brand new CD out. The name of it is Temptation 60. So when we got the word that we were going to do our 60th anniversary, Derek, our road manager, him and I were driving around one of LA's many freeways. I said, "Gee, man, we're getting ready to do our 60th anniversary CD." And I said, "It would only be fair right to have Smokey part of it." He said, "Well, you know, I'm calling." So I gave Smokey a call. I said, "Hey, Smoke." And he, for 62 years, he always referred to me as Oak. I said, "Smoke, we would love for you to do our 60th anniversary CD." "No problem, Oak." I said, "Okay, we would love for you to write it." "Oh, you got it, Oak." "We would love for you to produce it, and we would love for you to sing it." Oh, no problem, you got it. You know, so we went in the studio and did it, and the fellas left. And so Smokey and I, we were sitting there listening at the playback, and I would always take myself out and be an oldest of the gents, and I would be listening with critical ears to see if the harmonies and whatever was right. So everything was sounding pretty right, but I would look over at Smokey, and Smokey would have the damnedest look on his face. And I said, "Smokey, why are you looking like that?" He said, "I want to make sure it's right, because we want the ladies to be hot and bothered." You know, so, and Smokey, yeah, so the song that we're about to do for you, the young man to our left and right, he starts the song on that. He sounds so close to Smokey. You know what we call him? Chocolate Smokey. And the name of the song is it going to be yes or no? But touching is her sign. Lovely. Wonderful California horn section, ladies and gentlemen. Show your love. And they're all under the leadership of our own maestro himself from New York City. Sounds so nice, they spelled it twice. Let's give some love to the doctor. He's in the house tonight. Dr. Dennis Wigan. Well, now that you've met us vocally, we'd like to take this opportunity to introduce ourselves to you personally. Singing first tenor, second tenor, baritone, and a lot of lead. He's from Charlotte, North Carolina. Let's give a big California welcome to Mr. Tony Wright. Thank you. That's our James Brown in training, y'all. So
come back in about 10 years. He'll have that act together by then. Oh, yeah. The next gentleman, no matter where we travel in the world, when we call his name, the ladies scream real loud.
Five times, squad.
My God. Ladies, are you in here? So let's meet and greet Mr. Gentlemen, you see, we can't introduce him anymore as a new kid on the block because he's been with us a minute and he's doing a wonderful, wonderful job. You see, he comes from a play that was on Broadway and the play was about Otis Williams. And you know, he had such a wonderful voice in the play, deep voice. We decided we got to bring this brother on the road with us. Oh yeah. And guess what? He's doing a wonderful job. How about giving a big welcome from Detroit, Michigan to Mr. Jawan Jackson.
Oh, I need some little more.
Real good. I know he's proud. Thank you.
Oh yeah! Now, this next young man, you see, he's been with me for such a
too long.
Oh, long time. He hails from Philadelphia. Now he's a wonderful friend to have, and he's a great asset. But let me tell you what the young man can sing. He can sing some hellacious first tenor. The brother is cold on second tenor. All day long on Sweet Mary Dolly.
But he can't sing no bass, no high, no way. He can't sing no bass.
Now, what did you know? I can't sing no bass.
Go back to tenor. Let's say hi to the wonderful vocals of Mr. Ron.
question. Where my ladies at? Where my ladies at? Are my ladies over here? I got a better question. Where are all of the beautiful ladies at tonight? Well, ladies, this next song is for you. Fellas, we're not gonna leave you out, but we definitely gonna teach you a lesson tonight. Definitely. Y'all been having a good time so far? You've been a great audience. I've been having a fantastic time. But I feel like we can take this up another level. Can we do that? I feel like dancing tonight. Can I get the ladies to dance with me tonight? Can I get the ladies to dance with me tonight? Ladies, stand on your feet right where you are. Turn the lights up. I want to see all the ladies in the room. I want to see all the ladies. In the back, in the back. Come on, I want to see. Oh my God.
Thank you. ladies, if you know this, my brothers are here to the ladies, you know what I mean? We're on our way to Philly, y'all. Let's go!
This next song, you made it a billion streams worldwide. And we want y'all to take your cell phones out, turn your lights on, and sing the Temptations national anthem with us.
Come on, you people in California.